है, जो ईएमआई नहीं लिया लेना मत, नरे पर ओनली गोल। अब जो ले चुका तो ले चुका है। तो पे आ गया, पेन पेपर आ गया और आप रेडी। तो किरण भाई चूज करो, कोई ड्रीम चूज कर लो, मैं तुम्हें 2-3 चीज सिखाता हूँ, चूज कर लो, ड्रीम चूज कर लो, है ना। एक मिनट बिफोर यू गो, फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट पे क्लिक करो, लेफ्ट साइड पे फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट पे, और प्लीज ऑब्जर्व दिस केयरफुली। ओके, दिस इज नोन एज बैलेंस शीट। फाइनेंस गाइस अंडरस्टैंड ऑलरेडी, तो इफ यू आर फाइनेंस गाइस दिस इज क्वाइट ऑब्वियस फॉर यू, बट यू विल बी सरप्राइज्ड व्हेन अ फाइनेंस गाइ डू एरर्स व्हिच ही इज नॉट सपोज्ड टू डू। आई विल गिव सम बेसिक बेसिक लैंग्वेज टुडे। तो एक बैलेंस शीट में क्या होता है, इनकम होता है, एक्सपेंस होता है, एसेट होता है, लायबिलिटी होता है। अच्छा, आप लोगों ने कितने लोगों ने सुना है बचपन से घर एसेट होता है? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैड फ्रॉम चाइल्डहुड घर एसेट होता है? कम ऑन रेज हैंड मैन, ऑल ऑफ यू लाइक मी ओनली, राइट? सब सब हैंड रेज करो, सब पास, सबको लगा घर एसेट है। अभी देखो इसमें देखो तुम कहाँ पर है, तुम्हारा है घर किधर है, इस बैलेंस शीट में घर देखो किधर है, वो बैलेंस शीट में घर किधर है?
लायबिलिटीज में
तो क्या हुआ तुम्हारा घर?
लायबिलिटी
ये कंफ्यूजन कहां से आया फिर? सोच के देखो, घर अगर एसेट होता तो लायबिलिटी कॉलम में क्यों है? आई विल टुडे एक्सप्लेन यू 2 or 3 कॉन्सेप्ट, ठीक है? मैं आगे 2-3 चीज आपको क्लियरली समझाता हूं, पर समझ लो, सो दैट इन द गेम यू विल अंडरस्टैंड। देयर आर 4 कॉन्सेप्ट्स इनसाइड दिस गेम व्हिच यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड। नंबर 1, व्हाट इज एन एसेट, व्हाट इज अ लायबिलिटी? एसेट इज समथिंग व्हिच विल फेच मनी फॉर यू, व्हिच विल ब्रिंग मनी टू योर पॉकेट, करेक्ट ना? दैट इज एसेट। लायबिलिटी इज समथिंग व्हिच विल टेक अवे मनी फ्रॉम योर पॉकेट। लेमन लैंग्वेज सिंपल क्लियर है? अच्छा, अब इस घर को देखते हैं, जिस घर में आप रह रहे हो, आपके क्या हो रहा है, घर का लोन देखो, घर का लोन है 115,000। अब देखो ये केस में किरण जो है एक लॉयर है, तो उसकी सैलरी है $7,500 पर मंथ, तो उसके खर्चे भी उसी हिसाब से हैं, उसके घर का जो ईएमआई है वो भी ऑलमोस्ट इट इज ऑलमोस्ट 1,100। अभी बाकी लोगों का दिखाऊंगा तो देखना, ये अलग अलग बैलेंस शीट आएगा। किरण इज अ रिच गाय हियर, इज अ हाई इनकम पर्सन, तो उसका खर्चा भी उतना ही है। देखो किरण $7,500 कमा भी रहा है, तो $5,000 खर्च भी कर रहा है, ठीक है? बाकी लोगों को दिखाऊंगा, कोई ट्रक ड्राइवर रहेगा तो उसका खर्चा देखना, उसे घर देखना, ठीक है? अब इसका जो कार है वो होंडा सिटी से नीचे हो नहीं सकता, लॉयर आदमी है, बड़ा आदमी है, वो तो होंडा सिटी चलाएगा। अभी किसी का देखना सैलरी रहेगा $1,000, तो वो मारुति इनर चलाएगा, उसको क्या दिक्कत है? ही हैज नो स्टेटस प्रॉब्लम। तो बड़े आदमी को बड़े घर में रहना पड़ेगा, तो उसके घर का ईएमआई भी ज्यादा आ रहा है, $1,100 आ रहा है, बिग अमाउंट, इज इट? तो प्रॉब्लम इज व्हाई आई सेड होम इज अ लायबिलिटी। लिखो पेपर पे, मैं एक इक्वेशन देता हूँ, उस इक्वेशन मुझे एक भी घर दिखा दो बैंगलोर में, या तुम किसी भी सिटी में ले लो, मैं उड़ीसा में, उड़ीसा में मुझे एक ऐसा घर नहीं मिला। तो लेट मी टेक एन एग्जांपल, इंटरेस्ट जो आपके घर में क्या क्या कंपोनेंट है, डाउन पेमेंट होता है, लेट्स से आई वांट टू परचेज अ हाउस इन बैंगलोर, और लेट्स से इन दिल्ली, और लेट्स से आई वांट टू बाय इन भुवनेश्वर, वेयर एवर आई वांट टू बाय, तो उसके क्या करना पड़ेगा, एक बेसिक लेमन लैंग्वेज में डाउन पेमेंट करना पड़ेगा। डाउन पेमेंट जो तुम करोगे, लेटर से 50 लाख का घर है, 60 लाख का घर है, मैं डाउन पेमेंट 10 लाख का कर रहा हूँ, अगर उस डाउन पेमेंट को मैं अगर बैंक में डिपॉजिट कर दूं, लेट्स से आई डू एफडी, विल आई गेट 6% रिटर्न और नॉट? अगर मैं 10 लाख का डाउन पेमेंट कर दूंगा तो उसका 6% तो इंटरेस्ट रेट आएगा ना, तो 60,000 रुपए का इंटरेस्ट आएगा मेरा, दैट विल बी पैसिव इनकम। तो अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट हियर। तो इसका मतलब अगर आपका इक्वेशन समझना है घर खरीदने का, उसके बाद से तुम्हें एक भी घर काम का दिख जाए तो मुझे बताना। आई विल टेल यू 2 or 3 concept which all of you have in your mind. Number one, let's take an example. Your house is your rent of a house. If you are putting it on rent, rent minus EMI minus interest on the down payment. I repeat again, little all of you please write down this equation. Rent minus EMI minus interest on the down payment. It's a very simple equation. Now just do this analysis. Anybody who is having his own home right now in Bangalore, Delhi, doesn't matter whether it's a liability or asset, don't worry, it's already done. They already purchased it, so don't worry about it. So tell me, whoever has a own house here in Bangalore, Delhi, or anywhere, wherever you are right now, anybody who is owning your own house right now, kisi ka nahi hai, but nobody is having it. Saurav is having it. So Saurav, aapke ghar ki EMI kitni aa rahi hai? Whoever, anybody can participate. Dipti, what is your house EMI?
No EMI, sir, for home.
Okay. Dipti, what about you?
Mine is 27,000 per month.
Per month. Mine is 32,500.
32,500, okay. Agar abhi usko rent pe chala, toh Dipti, if you put your house in rent right now, let's take an example. How much would be the rent you will get from that house?
Okay.
Kitna?
How much rent is will be around 18 to 20k.
18,000? 15 to 18,000? Okay. Let's do simple mathematics. So rent, so it means Dipti will get a rent of 18,000. EMI is how much, Dipti?
32,500.
32,500. 32.5. Did you need some down payment?
Yeah, 32.
How much?
Down payment was 9 lakhs.
9 lakh? Okay, so 9 lakh down payment will end up into 6% return. Let's assume 6% return. 9 5 45, 9 6 54. 54,000 annually. So monthly it will come around how much? Around 5,000. Take approximately 4,500. 4.5. Equation says rent minus EMI minus interest on the down payment. So it is coming 18,000 minus 32,500 minus 4,500. Now let's take an example. So in this case, what is happening? It is almost 18,000 is minus 18,000 is the per month cash flow. This is known as cash flow. Now let us understand whether it is a good deal or a bad deal. Again, it will be decided by time. So let me first explain to all of you so that you understand. Anything is a good, anything is bad, because in future some house price also may increase. So I'm not denying that it will be totally liability, but let me explain to you the concept behind it. What happens typically with people is, I'll give a very good story to narrate the whole concept. There was a child and a father who were going on a, you know, basically they were going just on a typical outside, and the father was supposed to close a deal. He was for a business discussion and he took his son along. In between they found a place where some, you know, function was happening. So the son got excited. He said, "Father, I want a toy." And father said, "I don't have a single rupee. I cannot pay anything." The toy was of 100 rupees only, but he did not have 100 rupees also at that time. They said, "Don't worry, while coming, I'll give it to you." The son somehow said, "Okay, what can he do anyways?" He was frustrated. Then while returning back, so meanwhile his father was able to do a good deal. He got 15 lakh rupees business contract and he was very happy. He had some money now. So while returning, again they reached the same place. So the son again asked, "Dad, I want this toy." So, but this time the problem was the toy was of 300 rupees. While going it was 100 rupees. While returning back it is 300 rupees. Now the father is very excited. He gave it to him. The son said, "Man, father, while going it was just 100 rupees and you're saying you're not having. Now you're paying three times more. How it is possible? What happened?" He said, "See, son, while going I did not have a single rupee. While coming I have now 15 lakh rupees. So 300 rupees doesn't matter to me." What I'm trying to tell you, most of the people, the error they do is they buy the house in the early age. What is the assumption? Can you have to pay rent? So I'll buy. Problem they're facing is they're cash trapped. And what I mean to say, let's say today, any deal, now you have to become financial freedom. Another concept which you have to understand is the financial freedom, which this game will explain to you. Problem with EMIs are that in the young age, if you have EMI, your salaries are not that high. And if you're stuck in the EMI, you cannot take any risk in your life. Even if you get some business idea, let's say, which will not require huge capital, you will not be able to take even a single percent of risk in your life. And that will be a bottleneck for the person's growth. That is why it becomes a liability if you take it. Now imagine you have enough money. You're not having any EMI problem. In that case, it doesn't matter. The problem in the game, another concept you'll see in this game is somebody gets laid off. So one rule is I explain to you balance sheet. Then I explain to you concept of passive income. So what is passive income? Let's understand here. In this game, observe in the right-hand side where income is written. Just right-hand side, you observe, increase the passive income to the escape the rat race. Now, what is passive income? Passive income is when your, let's say, whatever expenses are coming. Now, in Kiran's case, the expenses which is coming overall is 5,030. That means if Kiran has to become financially free. Now, what is financial freedom? That you are not physically dependent upon your income. Now, how many of you believe financial freedom, the concept which is explained by this game, is relevant for your life? How many of you believe it is important for your life? If at all it is possible. I mean, possible or not, that is another game. In game, you will understand the concept. If it is there, how many of you believe it is important? All right, other people didn't understand the question, is it? Okay, let me explain to you financial freedom again. Financial freedom means your physical presence is not required to sustain your family. What does it mean? All of you now do this exercise for yourself right now. Because later on, you'll never be able to do. Make your balance sheet right away. Now, when I'm saying balance sheet, I'm not talking about exact number, because exact number is not required. Even if you are approximate numbers are there, let's take an example. Make your balance sheet right now, your income. How many sources of income you're having? If it is only job, then you know your salary, write it down. Then just approximately write down your expenses. In expenses, what all is included? Your house EMI, your children's school fees, if you have children. Whatever is the cost is involved in your survival, write down all those expenses, approximate numbers. That is your expense, which you cannot reduce, no matter what happens. So right now, do your balance sheet away, right away. Right away, do it, okay? expenses of yours per month include everything. You many times people forget their EMIs. They think EMI is not part of expense. That is also part of expense right now because you are paying it. All of you write down your expenses, approximate number. I don't know exact number. Like some of you calculate, okay, milk packet two are coming, so one packet is 21 rupees. I am not going to that granular level. I'm just an approximate number that I'm asking. That major, most of the major cost you take with 10% error here and there. Doesn't matter.
Vijay, I have a question here. So whatever amount that we use it to save, right? So should we also put it under expenses? Like, let's say
saving ka matlab kya? Saving ka matlab depend karo this.
Huh. Let's say if we are putting in some RD or something like that.
No, that recurring deposit, it comes in asset column. It is an asset column because it's your investment. The recurring deposit is an asset. So that is not, I'm talking expenses. Expenses in the
expenses.
Case, all the EMIs of house you are paying, that is expense. RD and all is not expenses because that is eventually investment. So that comes under asset column. It will be your asset column.
Okay, got it.
All the EMIs come under liabilities, so they will have expenses. If you observe the balance sheet, income expense. All the expenses, if you see in the bottom right hand side, liabilities are there. Like say home loan is coming. So home mortgage is 115,000. Home mortgage payment is 1,100 per month. This is your expenses. So liabilities have expenses. That is what I mean to say. So let's say you have a children. So every child will have a school fees. So though you may be paying annually 1.5 lakh rupees, so just make it monthly 12,000. So that will be easy for you to calculate, or 13,000 like that. So all those basic expenses you write down. Now under this condition, all of you tell me, what is the expense did you all found right now? All of you. The more people participate, the more better, because the idea is participate so that you learn.
Vijayji, from my end, so I'm just paying the EMI some certain amount to my personal loan and some amount to my home needs. And I'm
so
just...
जो भी आप EMI pay कर रहे हो ना, भले वो आप loan के लिए pay कर रहे हो, सब liability में आ गया ना, तो आपका खर्चा तो है ही ना वो. Any EMI you are paying, that is your expense, correct na?
Yes.
The LIC EMI you are paying. LIC is not a EMI. LIC comes under any LIC, as LIC okay. Any company policy, that is not under expense. That is not expenses. That is coming under your investment, because that will be considered as your asset, right? Jo aapne personal loan liya, let's say you've taken a personal loan of 10 lakh. That EMI you are putting, that is your expense only, correct? So that is comes under expense. All of you do this. Is a very.
What about the insurance?
Insurance will come under EMIs. It is as of now, it is part of the expense only. Yes, it is expense only.
Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
Anybody have somebody say? I muted because
I want to speak. My name is Chaitra.
Please. Yeah. Please.
Sir, I have constructed the house long back 10 years only, and my EMI has been finished. And I have kept mortgage as the house, and I have taken again 2 plots as a land I have taken. Whether this is come in liability or asset?
Are you paying right now? See, I'll give a very simple fundamental science. Are you paying EMI right now?
Yeah, I am paying EMI.
EMI will come under expense. That land will come under your asset column. That land, though it is not fetching any immediate income, that will come in the game. So, but that will put in the asset column. So that will
asset
go
into asset column.
Even if the land is of 10 lakhs or 20 lakh, you have put it. That comes into asset column, but it is not fetching income right now.
Immediately, we are not generating the income from that one.
Correct.
Yeah.
But you pay EMI, but right now it's a liability for
you. It is liability. For this reason, we are not able to go for any other purpose because of this big EMI.
While the game is going on, you will see a lot of interesting things. This is all things I am explaining in advance, so that when the game goes, we don't go quite faster. So this is all of you, please write down your expenses. All the EMIs are part of your expenses. All of you do it, right? Expenses, please calculate the expense. Jaldi, jitna jaldi karoge, utna jaldi apan aage badhenge. There are a lot of interesting concepts you'll learn. Expense sabka nikal gaya, please write down what is your expense. All of you write down. Let's learn from each other. All married, I'll tell you thumb rule without even knowing you. Married people without kid in Bangalore, cost of living is 60 to 70,000. If you stay in Koramangala, 80,000. If you stay in Horamabu, 70,000. If you stay somewhere inside electronic city, somewhere where a GPS signal is lost, 60,000. I'm just telling you the rent of the cost to make your life easier. So, okay, that is how it will go. So 60,000, 70,000. Bachche ke saath agar aap ho, if you are with kids, then your one kid expenses per year is 1.5 lakh rupees to 2 lakhs. One kid expense. Including school fees and all the damages he do. He spoils so many things at home every day. Have you realized? I have two boys. So that is also part of liability. They'll every day break something or other. And you keep on getting angry, they'll keep on breaking more. That all comes under liability. What to do? Parenting cost. Some people are so innocent, they're only adding school fees. I say, what are the damages which they're doing? They break every month one tap. They break something either here and there. They throw something, some ball damage, something damage. My goodness. And if you have two boys, extra expenditure per month, 5,000. That's a liability column. All of you had it. Okay, done. So you now know what is your cost of living. Is this clear to all of you? Cost of living, it includes all your EMIs, whether it is insurance EMI, whether it is your land EMI, whether it is a school EMI, whatever you are paying, with the car EMI, all comes under your expenses. Now, why am I saying this? I will show you magic right now. This magic will blow your mind and you will not sleep today night. My whole idea is to wake you up so that you don't sleep anymore. I did this, I played this game in 2008. I was not able to sleep. I said, man, where am I going? I'm in the wrong direction. And then immediately I took some course correction, and later on 5 years I was out of my job later on. So I'll give you another. Okay, sabka, sab ne expenses likh liya. All of you have written down your expenses. Okay. That is nice. So expenses are clear now. अभी मैं एक और चीज बताऊंगा, अभी तुम लोग टेंशन आ जाएगा सबके सब. ना आप ध्यान से देखो, इस गेम के अंदर में एक और चीज होगा. तो अभी तक गेम में क्या क्या समझ में आया हमें? इनकम, एक्सपेंस, एसेट एंड लायबिलिटी. फोर कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर क्लियर. So far, so good. Okay. Now, what is the goal? Goal is, in this game, your total expenses should be generated by a passive income. Why? Because it is generated by passive income. You are not worried about making money. You can live life in your terms and conditions. And all of you now honestly answer. If you are, you are having passive income more than your expenses right now, assume right now, just visualize, for temporarily visualize for 5 minutes. Whatever is your expense, 1 lakh or 1.5 lakh or 50,000 or 60,000, doesn't matter. If that much of passive income you are making, passive income means it do not need your physical presence. How many of you would be excited to go a job this coming Monday? Think upon it. This answer then, okay? Practically, if you are able to make passive income as good as your expenses, more than that, kitne log job jaane mein excited rahoge? Genuinely, okay? कि बाकी लोग अगर जॉब जाने तो मैं देखा बहुत ज्यादा एक्साइटेड नहीं है. कितने लोग होंगे जो अपने लाइफ में अपने हिसाब से जिंदगी जीना चाहोगे? इन योर टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन अदर देन डूइंग जॉब यू विल डू समथिंग व्हिच यू वांटेड टू डू लॉन्ग टाइम बैक. सोचिए देखो, आई रिपीट माय क्वेश्चन अगेन स्लोली. इफ यू आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू मेक मनी फॉर योर सर्वाइवल ऑफ लाइफ, दैट मीन्स यू हैव क्रिएटेड फाइनेंशियल फ्रीडम. नाउ हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू रादर देन गोइंग जॉब यू विल ट्राई टू डू समथिंग व्हिच यू वांटेड टू डू बट यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू राइट नाउ? No, I'm not telling you quit a job, by the way. All of you can continue your job, no issue at all. I have no problem with job. I have also done job for 13 years. I'm just asking, giving a direction to think that if you have it, how many of you would be? So this is a difficult question to answer because most of people may not even understand what I'm saying. It will take time to understand. Okay? But basic samjha. Ab dekho dusri cheez samajhte hain life mein. In this game, somewhere down the road, one person can get laid off also because game mein life as a job chali jati kabhi kabhi. Ab ek aur answer karo. जैसे आप ले ऑफ हो जाओगे, लेट्स से समबडी गेट्स लेड ऑफ इन दिस गेम, विल हिज एक्सपेंसेस गेट जीरो? सपोज किसी की जॉब चली गई, क्या उसका खर्चा जीरो हो जाएगा? क्या उसके घर का ईएमआई खत्म हो जाएगा? क्या उसके बच्चे का स्कूल का फीस खत्म हो जाएगा? करेक्ट नॉट? दैट मींस इफ समबडी गेट्स लेड ऑफ, इफ समबडी गेट्स लेड ऑफ, हु विल टेक केयर ऑफ देयर फैमिली इज अ क्वेश्चन मार्क नाउ. सो नाउ हियर आई विल टेल यू वन मोर असाइनमेंट टू डू, बिकॉज द मोमेंट इन दिस गेम व्हाट विल हैपन, इफ समबडी इज लेड ऑफ इन बिटवीन, 2 months of salary will be deducted from his account. 2 months of expenses. What it means is, now see, observe Kiran's statement here. He's having cash of 400 rupees, cash. That means after his, though his salary is 7,500, but finally his expenses are 5,030. To begin with, he has only cash of 400. Now, assuming if Kiran's job goes away in this game, then what will happen immediately is 10,060 rupees will be deducted from his bank balance. As of now, is Kiran having 10,600? No, he's having only 400 rupees saving. Check it. Are you able to see? Now, this is not a game. See the real life now. How many of you can live the same life without your job for how many months? Let's take an example. Saving the clothes. Now, take an example. Some of you wrote your cost of living is 1 lakh rupee or 1.5 lakh rupee. Now, just see your bank balance, or even if you have done an FD which you can break, something which you can liquidate right away. How many months can you sustain your life without impacting your lifestyle? Suppose अभी आपकी जॉब चली जाती है, आपके पास इतनी सेविंग है क्या? कितने महीने आप अपनी लाइफ को जी सकते हो without impacting your life. Write it down. I hope my question is clear. If your job goes away, your expenses will be still the same. How many months can you live without your job with the same lifestyle? Check karo. All of you think upon it. Jaldi karo, jaldi. These are all simple basics. Once you understand this much of basics, then the game will be very interesting. But then I'll show you in 4 rounds what all lessons you've learned.
Max 2-3.
Bharat, what are you
saying? Maximum 1 or 2 months we can survive.
Maximum 1 or 2 months. See, let me see the answer. Can we see the right answer for all of us? Most of the people have even one. Except 1 or 2 people. Mohit, bachelor ho gaya? Ek saal likha Mohit ne. Bachelor ho gaya?
No, I'm married.
Oh, gajab yaar. Married hone wala Maheshwari. मारवाड़ी आदमी हो समझदार हो जस्ट किडिंग नथिंग टू वरी
नो प्रॉब्लम
ओके मोस्ट ऑफ पीपल से ऑब्जर्व द डेटा राइट नाउ अदर प्लीज पार्टिसिपेट बिकॉज़ दिस विल एजुकेट यू फाइनेंशियल योर फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी विल कम ओनली इफ यू पार्टिसिपेट ऑलराइट अदरवाइज दिस विल बी थ्योरेटिकल गेम फॉर यू इट्स अ वर्ल्ड रिनाउंड गेम बाय द वे इट इज नॉट डिजाइन बाय मी इट इज डिजाइन बाय वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एक्सपर्ट इन दिस एरिया Now let's see, it is more or less, if you observe, most of you are 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, very few 1 year. What does that show us? Now, if you observe, what is happening in this condition is that our fund, now coming back to the same question, is a home asset or a liability? Think upon it now. Where most of the middle class families are stuck in life is, I'll tell you what happens. They are not having enough cash. They are taking lot of EMIs. अब मैं जब game खेलूँगा तो आपको थोड़ा अभी concept को मैं game के दौरान सिखाऊँगा. अभी मैंने आपको basic concept सिखा दिया. So let me summarize what are the concept I explained you by now. I explained you the concept of asset, liability, income and expenses. That's a basic financial statement I've shown you. Then what I told you was an equation of what is a positive cash flow, what is a negative cash flow. Cash flow का मतलब है अगर आप किसी चीज का pay करने के बाद If money is coming in your pocket, that is known as cash flow. जैसे इस केस में देखो किरण का कैश फ्लो को अगर हम ऑब्जर्व करेंगे किरण का इनकम है $7,500, his expense is $5,030. तो किरण's cash flow is $2,470 per month. Cash flow का मतलब खर्चा होने के बाद जो बचेगा वो है कैश फ्लो अंडर दिस कंडीशन इफ आई टेक सेम कैश फ्लो का अगर इक्वेशन मैंने घर का बना के दिया था आपको फॉर अ हाउस द कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट विल बी रेंट माइनस EMI Minus interest on the down payment. So under this condition, now onwards, whenever you see any opportunity, अब जो ले चुके हैं उसका tension मत लो. That is anyway you have gone, so nothing to regret now. Move on. It's lack of ignorance. It's lack of knowledge. But from now onwards, if anybody says you any deal, आपको से simple calculation करना है. You need to create positive cash flow for me. If it is not creating positive cash flow for me, the problem you will face is you will be stuck in life. कभी free हो ही नहीं पाओगे. अब मैं उसको example देखा था. Now let's roll the game. So Kiran, roll it now. Now let's start. तो मैं फटाफट कुछ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑन द फ्लाई सिखाऊंगा तो चैरिटी दे दो तुम चैरिटी के लिए पैसे नहीं होंगे यू डू नॉट हैव 10% तो क्या करो पास यू डू नॉट हैव चैरिटी मनी ओके एंड नेक्स्ट जल्दी जाओ ऑल ऑफ यू कीप शेयरिंग फटाफट कार्तिक शेयर योर स्क्रीन किरण मूव योर स्क्रीन रिमूव योर स्क्रीन एंड लेट कार्तिक शेयर कार्तिक जल्दी ले ऑल ऑफ यू बी रेडी आफ्टर कार्तिक जिसका भी है यू शेयर योर स्क्रीन राइट अवे ओके सो यू चूज इट एनी ड्रीम यू चूज फॉर पर्पस ऑफ नॉलेज एनी ड्रीम यू चूज डजंट मैटर Okay, choose it and it's financial statement. Please show my financial statement in the left hand side financial statement. Go up. Now see, he's a truck driver. Now observe the difference between a truck driver and Kiran. Truck driver's home EMI is $400, whereas lawyer's home EMI was $1,100. Because lawyer is staying in posh area, Kormungla, and he want to stay in a right house. Now whereas a truck driver, but he don't care. He says, I can stay anywhere, man. I have no problem. A truck driver can stay in a 1 BHK also. It doesn't have 1 BHK concept. So his expenses are less. If you observe, cash flow kitna hai? Kiran ke paas 7,500 ka salary hone ke bawajood, his cash flow was how much, Kiran? 2,000 something or how much was the cash flow?
2,400 something.
2,400. Now observe this. Kartik is having 2,500 as an income, whereas his cash flow is 880 rupees. Are you able to see? Payday. See the payday. Cash ke niche pe payday likha hua hai. Kartik's cash flow is $880. कार्तिक का सब एक्सपेंस कम है, जो कार उसका छोटा कार है $80 का कार पेमेंट है, उसका किरण का $220 है, वो होंडा सिटी चला रहा था और ये चला रहा है आराम से अपना मारुति, इसको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं मारुति से, ये आराम से भैया मेरी गाड़ी चलने से मतलब है। आर यू सीइंग द डिफरेंस? द मोर यू आर एट द बिगर पोजीशन द मोर एक्सपेंसेस विल इनकर इन योर लाइफ एनीवेज, करेक्ट और नॉट? लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल, सक्सेसफुल पर्सन स्कूल्स विल बी एक्सपेंसिव स्कूल, वेयर एज अ ट्रक ड्राइवर कैन सेंड हिज चिल्ड्रन टू अ गवर्नमेंट स्कूल आल्सो वेयर देयर विल बी हार्डली 200 रुपीस फीस, देयर इज अ बिग डिफरेंस। I'm just showing the expenses. Is it clear to all of you? This is how balance it works. Roll. Now roll your dice. Finish your turn. End. Next, Jalya, Bharat, be ready. Share a screen. Remove your screen. End karo pehle. Karthik, end. Until you end, Bharat cannot go. End it. The end button is there. Click on the end button. Yes, Bharat, go ahead. Share your screen. All of you be ready with the screen sharing. Yes, choose. Anything you choose, doesn't matter. Right now, anything?
Yeah, Vishay bhai. We are also truck driver, or what?
Shabash. You are also a truck driver. All truck drivers are will become free faster. The biggest challenge you will face is a doctor. Their income is $10,000 and their expenses are $7,500. They find very difficult to become financially free. All right, choose it. Anything you choose, whatever you like. Want to become a film star? Very good. Roll. Karo. Clear? Ye to main samjha diya hu, so that we can skip now. Move. Roll. Donate to charity. Donate kar do, koi dikkat nahi. Donate karne se fayda hoga. Tumko 3 chance milega. Next. End karo. Next.
Sashi,
you can go ahead. Share karo. Sashi ka screen share karo. शशि के बाद जिसका भी पारी है वो अपना स्क्रीन के साथ रेडी रहो, सो दैट इमीडिएटली गो विदाउट टाइम लैग। चूज कर लो, कोई भी ड्रीम चूज करो। फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट दिखाओ तुम्हारा क्या है शशि, व्हाट इज योर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट? यू आर आल्सो योर बिजनेस मैनेजर, ये बीडीएम है, इसका सैलरी 4,600 है। देखो इसका कार का होम मॉर्गेज देखो 700 है, कार्तिक का था 400 आई थिंक, एंड किरण हैज 1100। सी द डिफरेंस, बिकॉज़ द मोर एक्सपेंसेस द मोर बेटर लाइफ यू वांट टू लीव, दैट इज हाउ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आर, नेचुरल, इट्स क्वाइट नेचुरल। So his cash flow is 1,730. Out of 4,600, his cash flow is 1,730. That is good. So choose any dream, no problem. Choose. Roll. Small. Hana option is small deal. A deal pe click karo, small deal pe click karo, small. Because you have small amount, small deal pe click karo. Now observe this. What did you do? Abhi jo land ka kisi ne se pucha tha, right? Dekho, land mein agar down payment karke aapka paisa atak gaya, is it an asset or a liability? Now that will be decided by two things. Number one, if your entire money is stuck, now I'll give you an idea. I have a practical idea, though this will give a great observation here. Abhi ek simple theoretical, hypothetically, main aapko ek acha example deta hun. Assume you get a market mein deal milegi aapko, which needs 20,000 rupees per month investment. Assume, I'm just giving a deal right now. And in next 5 years, it can give you financial freedom. It will fetch you, let's say your expenses are 90,000, that business deal can fetch you 1 lakh rupee monthly income after 5 years, which is passive in nature. And you have purchased a land which have taken away your 35 lakhs rupees. Is it a good deal or bad deal now? I repeat again, dhyan se suno. Right now, you are working as a software engineer. You have 7 years of experience. I'm just giving a practical scenario because some of the 1% just before the game, they said, right, let's say purchase a land. Now, because of land, he's not having any cash to invest anything. Correct? That happens with most of us. So land is not a bad deal, by the way, it's a good deal. But again, good and bad is decided by two parameters. Parameter number one, after doing the down payment, are you cash broke? If you're cash broke, then it is a very pathetic deal because now you cannot do anything in your life. You cannot become rich. You cannot do any business. You are stuck because anything will need money. Now take an example, practical scenario I'm telling you. You purchase a land of 30 lakh rupees. Now you do not know when this land will grow. Now I'll tell you a practical scenario. When I started my career in 2006 in Bangalore, in 2007, I purchased a land in Cuttack. Now, Cuttack near Bidanasi area, which is a quite popular area in Odisha, Cuttack. I purchased a land of 10,000 square feet land. Now, listen carefully. That time, I paid around 9 lakhs to 10 lakhs. And people projected that it will grow exponentially. It will become 1 to 2 crore. Now, it is how many years? 2007 se mere kitna saal ho gaya bhai? Almost 13 saal ho chuka hai. Abhi bhi agar main wahan ke land price, corona is an exceptional case. 6 mahine pehle chala jaun, December tak bhi le lu. My land price did not even went to 18 lakhs till now. What does it shows? Boss, that 7 lakh rupee got stuck. Now, what is the good news? The 7 lakh rupees I was having, which was really stressed because I did not have any money problem. 7 lakh dal diya, apne dal diya. But what I'm seeing, it has not grown to the way people are projecting. They are projecting that it will grow till 1 crore. No. 7 lakh has only come till 17, 18 lakhs only. Now, under this condition, what I'm trying to tell you, when you take land, there is no harm. After taking land, after taking a land, if you do not have any money, then it is an absolutely pathetic deal. Why? Because if some business opportunity comes in your life, just I give an example, you get a business deal which can give you financial freedom in the next 5 years, and you just need 20,000 rupees per month investment. And you are not able to do it only for what reason? I don't have cash. Now, do you want to be in that situation in your life? Absolutely not. So that's why, is it a good deal? It's actually a good deal. But the problem is 10 acre land lene ke baad isse khane ke liye paise nahi bachenge. Problem yahan se aayega. But some people do that risk, and I know a lot of people. So I'll give an example. Click on the buy button. Click on the buy button, Sasi. Let's observe. Kya dikha raha hai par? Ek monthly loan aayega $300 ka. Dhyan se dekho. What I am trying to tell you, he do not have 5,000 rupees right now. He is having 2,000 rupees, so 3,000 rupees loan lena padega. Loan lene ke baad mein uska interest kitna aa raha? $300 per month aa raha, right? That means this loan will come under liability column. Expense column mein $300 badh jayega. And his jo cash flow hai iska 1,730, that can reduce to 300. And what is the problem? What if tomorrow in next 10 years the land price do not increase? Trust me, it is true. If you do not believe it, I will tell you a lot of challenges of real estate in later on. So once you'll go, but is it clear now? Land acha hai ki kharab hai, sabko samajh mein aaya? Land is not a bad deal. It is not a good deal. Decided by two conditions. If you have overflow money, that money you can park. But if you do not have, and what is overflow money? Let me give you that perspective also today, because you're understanding this game. Anybody who is married, our first responsibility is that our family should not be under stress financially. What does that mean? Supposingly, my monthly expenses are 80,000 rupees per month. I want minimum 1 to 2 years of backup. That I should not touch. Why? Because that time land you cannot sell off. Let's say today I want to sell off my land. I need some urgency money. It will not even go in 17 lakhs. It will go in 10 lakhs rupees. So it is total wastage of my money. That means you want a liquid cash of at least 1 to 2 years of your expenses. Anybody who is married, whatever is your monthly expense, your goal should be, boss, 2 years of cash I should have in my home. Practically, if 80,000 is your cost of living, then you need minimum 16 lakhs rupees hard cash. Now, that cash you can do in FD. Your FD can be broken in less than 2 days. That is always possible. But otherwise, you're in deep trouble. Why? Because you'll be always financially broke. I hope that I have given a great concept right now. Now, I'm not even the best financial advice, by the way. Some people are good in stock market. I'm not denying that. But I'll tell you what the definition of good ones it comes, I'll show you. Is it clear? Land ka problem solve ho gaya? Is this concept clear to all of you? When is land a good deal and when is a bad deal? If you have enough cash flow, if you have 2 years of saving in your hand for a family to sustain, that remaining money you put whatever you want, because now you have some risk-taking capacity. But unfortunately, most of the people cannot even live for 3 months in their life. Under this condition, buying a land is a crime. Not even a good deal, it's a crime. Because you'll be unnecessarily risking your family. That is the whole idea. So no karo, and move on. I hope you are getting good education. Pass. It's a pass. Okay, end karo. So next, Jali, who is the next? Kiran, roll karo. Karthik, be ready. Now, small deal pe click karo. Observe it. That's amazing. Stock market. Now, this is also a very good concept. I'll explain you. Now, is it a good deal or bad deal? Dhyan se dekho. Is it a good deal or a bad deal? You have to answer. Is it a good deal or a bad deal? Whatever you answer, why? Why you answer? Acha, maybe unmute karta hu. What is a good deal or a bad deal?
It cannot be a good deal because the trending range is from $5 to $30 only, right?
Correct. That is a bad deal. But now let me come to real scenario. It's a game. In real scenario, will you ever know the range like this? Abhi tumko itna aasan se range bata de raha. Real life range pata hoga kya? Will you ever know the range in real life? Not possible. Because exception, I'll tell you what happened. Exception. Some people are good in this. Those who invested 10 years. Now, for real estate also, let me give one good advice. In my experience of mentoring, coaching a lot of people. If somebody has seen the entire sinusoidal cycle, then he's expert. What is sinusoidal cycle? Let's say if you had never lose any money in say of stock market, then I'm telling you, you have not seen the real world. Why? A time will come when you lose entire. So if somebody says, sir, I have made 20 lakh rupees from stock market, then I lost 30 lakh rupees, then again I made 20 lakh rupees, then I believe in this guy. Why? Because he has seen the ups, he has seen the down. Problem with most of people is, they have only seen up and they think they are expert in that area. My question was, when you see the down, can you handle that shock and move on? If yes, not only move on, can you succeed? Like in my business cycle, I am in business world for 12 years now. In my business world, I have succeeded, I have failed miserably, then again I succeeded. So now I have enough entrepreneurship experience. Same my coaching experience. I tried, I could not, I succeeded, I failed. Now, steady last 7-8 years, I know exactly how things work. That means until you have not seen the entire sinusoidal cycle, that means you have not got actual expertise. You're just relying on certain data, which is good for you, but I don't wish bad luck to you for sure. But when reality will hit your door, that time you'll see whether you can handle. Because I've seen a lot of stock market people, they've made money in the good days. When they fall to a level where they have to do suicide later on. Because there's nothing in their hand. That's the whole idea. So it's a common sense, it's a bad deal because you are not having anything. Correct. Next, Karthik, be ready. So Kiran, Karthik, go ahead. I hope stock market ka idea mil gaya hoga. So you got stock market idea, real estate idea, land idea. Now go ahead. Oh, small deal. घर आएगा अभी घर का डील आना चाहिए घर का आएगी नहीं क्लिक करो स्मॉल स्मॉल पे क्लिक करो ये देखो ये अच्छा क्वेश्चन है सिस्टर इन लॉ आस्किंग मनी जॉब चला गया सिस्टर इन लॉ का सो सिस्टर इन लॉ डाउनसाइज नीड 5000 टू मेक अ हाउस पेमेंट अब देखो ये टिपिकल कॉन्सेप्ट समझो व्हेन यू गेट लेड ऑफ योर हाउस पेमेंट इज स्टिल देयर राइट लॉट ऑफ पीपल डू दैट मिस्टेक दे हैव टेकन द होम ईएमआई नाउ सडनली द जॉब गोज आउट टेल यू रियल सिनेरियो ओके वन ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट्स रियल सिनेरियो टेल यू ही वाज एन अमेजिंग गाय ही पास्ड आउट फ्रॉम सेफील्ड यूनिवर्सिटी amazing chap who was working in Amazon. I'm talking about a story of 2014. Okay. Now 14 to 20, last 6 years, he had been laid off seven times. Seven times he had been laid off. He purchased a home in 2012. That time the real estate hasn't promised in Jalahalli. I'm talking about Bangalore, Jalahalli. I think 60, 70 lakhs was the house cost at that time. And he did some down payment, he purchased the house and they projected, obviously in Bangalore, they projected, right? The houses will become 2 crores very easily, nothing to worry. And that's what the agents always say. So he ended up buying. Everything was good. After Amazon, he moved on to a mid-sized company with a good hike. And suddenly that company got closed. He got laid off. 6 months without job. Now 6 months without job, who is going to pay the EMIs? He took personal loan. Then that loan EMI started increasing. Life became difficult. Then he got a job. Again, after getting a job, 4 months later, again, he got laid off. Now he was in deep trouble. What to do? He has to sell off his house. While selling off his house, he has to sell off at 10 lakh rupees less. So for him, now what I'm trying to tell you, if you'd have waited for 20 years, who knows, the price would have increased. But the problem we all are facing is, none of us have cash flow to sustain the challenges of life. The challenges of life can come to anybody that is of life, who knows. If it comes that point in time, what do you do? So this is what the story is saying, that sister-in-law got downsized, she need house payment, 5,000, and she promises to pay you back 10,000 after she finds her new job. Now, if you have enough cash flow, you should give it to her. Otherwise, there is not a good idea. Because whenever I lend money to any of my relatives, I always see it will not come back. If it come back, I feel my karma is good. Otherwise, I always see it will not come back. So anyways, I have 1,630 rupees. I will not do it. I will say, sorry, Baba, I don't have it. So that's how. Are you getting the concept or not? Because all these cards have a concept to explain to you. So move on. Pass. You don't have to. Next, Bharat, get ready. After Bharat, two dice. You did charity, right? So you got two dice. So your salary credit ho gaya, dekho. Son's college tuition, dekho. College tuition, your son want to prepare for IIT. Dekho, kharcha aise padta hai. Lot of people are assuming expenses will not come. Iska IIT ka tuition aa gaya, dekho, $1,500 gaya. Pay karo, option nahi hai. You have no choice, man. You have to pay. Take a loan, see? Now, there's an arrogative idea. You don't have money, but your son needs an education. What do? Take loan. There's no other option. You have to take loan. Take yes. See, loan lena padega. Bachche ko padhna kya karega? Pay karna padega. Pay karo. Pay now. Pay. You have taken a loan. What has happened is actually what has happened in this equation. He was not having the money, but student fees cannot be stopped. So he has to take a bank loan. After taking the loan, now see the bank statement. Financial statement, dekho. See the financial statement. Dekho, loan payment ho gaya $100.
Loan payment $100.
Correct na? Yeah. What has happened? That EMI. तो नीचे देखो लोन नीचे यहाँ पर $1,000 रियल एस्टेट के ऊपर देखो लायबिलिटी में $1,000 का लोन लेना पड़ा करेक्ट ही वाज हैविंग दैट मच ऑफ कैश ऑन यू क्लियर नाउ दैट इज व्हाई इट इज सो इंपॉर्टेंट ऑल दोस हु आर हैविंग किड्स आई एम टेलिंग यू बॉस जमीन खरीदने की तो सपना छोड़ दो पहले बेसिक बैकअप बना लो कि ना कब कैलेमिटी आएगी पता नहीं चलेगा तो बी रेडी विद द कैश एटलीस्ट एक से डेढ़ साल का लिक्विड कैश कंपल्सरी है इन माई एक्सपीरियंस इफ यू वॉन्ट टू लिव लाइफ विद मेंटल पीस अदरवाइज यू विल बी ट्रेमेंडस ट्रबल एंड नेक्स्ट शशि गेट रेडी I hope you got a lot of good concept today. Sasi bhai, Sasi ka kya ho gaya? फिनिश वहां पर अपना फिनिश करो टर्न भरत अपना टर्न फिनिश करो किसका टर्न था उसके पहले क्या था एंड एंड करो उस पे एंड करो एंड पे क्लिक करो ना तुम्हारा टर्न एंड नहीं
हां डन डन डन
हां करेक्ट रोल करो शशि रोल इसको अचानक दोस्तों आ गए दर्शन ने सेड व्हेन डोंट हैव फ्रेंडशिप विद ऑल दोस इडियट पीपल यू विल बी ट्रबल दे सेड मैन चलो वीकेंड में कैसीनो चलेंगे $200 गया
गोवा के लिए वो लास वेगास वाला
गोवा 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 जाओगे तो भैया $4,000 गया $200 इज कैसीनो अचानक एमजी रोड चलेंगे चलो जाके आते हैं खत्म पैसा डन यू टू पे देयर इज नो ऑप्शन दीस आर नोन एज डू दैट In Rich Dad Poor Dad, they say do dads. These are do dads which you cannot stop. They will come in your life. Pay. You have no option. Pay. I hope you all are learning life lesson, huh? Good. End. End. Next. Kiran, go ahead. Now, look. This is salary. Small, small deal. Small deal. So, this is very important. This is a very nice question. See this carefully. जो मैं तुम लोग कैश फ्लो समझाया था इसको समझो क्या बोल रहा है The down payment is $5,000. Okay. The house cost is $60,000. Cash flow is minus 100. Is it a good deal or bad deal?
Bad deal.
Yes, bad deal. But. एक और काम करते हैं. Buy पे क्लिक करो. मैं तुम्हें एक बस equation दिखाना चाहता हूँ. Buy पे क्लिक करो. तो बाय पे क्लिक करने से $300 का ईएमआई आएगा इसका मतलब माइनस 400 हो जाएगा समझ रहे हो माइनस 400 हो जाएगा 100 तो ऑलरेडी माइनस हो रहा है दैट्स व्हाट इज अ बैड डील नाउ नो करो वापस नो करो बट आई विल टेल यू व्हाट विल हैपन योर पेरेंट्स योर रिलेटिव्स विल से यार खरीद लो बाद में घर का प्राइस बढ़ेगा कोई दिक्कत नहीं है ₹100 ईएमआई जा रहा जाने जाए नो लॉट ऑफ पीपल डू दैट एरर अगेन इट इज नॉट बैड डील अगर अभी किरण के पास $15,000 होता आई विल टेल यू व्हाट आई वुड हैव डन इफ किरण वुड बी हैविंग $15,000 देन दैट इज ओके मैन 5000 दे दो को फर्क नहीं पड़ता You know, minus 100 rupees ke later on if some buyer come and buy at 60,000 my benefit will come you know not so it can be a good deal provided you have a overflow money abhi kiran ke paas mein basic expense ka paisa nahi hai uska basic expense is 5030 he is having only a saving of 2870 that means he should have minimum 15,000 rupees to sustain his life so that he can buy this house is it clear now pass next Karthik get ready patapat Small deal. No stock again. Now this is a good or bad?
Seems to be a good.
Again, some of them were stock expert. Otherwise, in real life, what will happen? You will never get those range. The range is known to you here, so it is easy. In this case, again, in real life scenario, Karthik is having only 1 month salary saving. His expenses are how much? 1,620. How much saving he is having? 2,510. That means 1,000 rupees worth risk he can take maximum right now. Beyond this, if he takes a risk, he will be in deep trouble. Though it is a good deal, no bad in it. It's a good deal. But the problem is, if he become total bankrupt, if some dude comes, some tennis ball comes, somebody comes and somebody breaks a leg, then what will it happen? He will not have money to go to hospital also. So this is a good deal, but timing is wrong. Are you getting point? Deal is good, but timing is wrong. So, but still, okay, for game purpose, I'll buy. You can buy 100 stocks. You can buy 100. Add 2 zeros. 100 stock kar lo. 1,000 I'm just giving. In real life, I'll not go for it. Because kharcha sa malne paisa nahi na. And next, Bharat, get ready. Yes. Yes, Bharat, go ahead. Two dice. Roll 2 dice. हाँ स्मॉल डील स्मॉल पे जाओ सी अगेन इट्स अ गुड वन इट्स अ गुड क्वेश्चन ऑल ऑफ यू ऑब्जर्व द हाउस कॉस्ट इज $65,000 डाउन पेमेंट इंडियन टर्म में समझाऊं तो इंडियन टर्म में ये बोलना चाह रहा है तुम्हारा घर का जो कॉस्ट है वो है 50 लाख अज्यूम करो 50 लाख इज द हाउस कॉस्ट तुम्हारा डाउन पेमेंट है 5 लाख ठीक है और तुम्हारा जो मंथली कैश फ्लो का मतलब है रेंट माइनस ईएमआई minus interest on down payment is $160 which is 15,000 or whatever 5,000 kuch bhi le lo it is a good deal but again timing is wrong why dekho इसके पास कितना कैश है अभी 1660 करेक्ट ना इज हैव ओनली 1660 डील इज गुड नॉट बैड बट द आर यू ऑब्जर्विंग टू गेट पैसिव इनकम इज सो डिफिकल्ट हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू ऑब्जर्व राइट नाउ दैट गेटिंग पैसिव इनकम डील इज नॉट इजी नाउ व्हेन आई से रिच डैड पुअर डैड कंफ्यूज लॉट ऑफ पीपल ऑन दिस इज व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन मेनी पीपल दे अज्यूम रिच डैड पुअर डैड बुक इज टॉकिंग अबाउट कि अगर वो घर खरीदेगा तो दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कैपिटल गेन नाउ व्हाट इज कैपिटल गेन लेट मी एक्सप्लेन टू यू यू बाय अ हाउस इन 50 लाख You sell in 70 lakhs, 20 lakh rupee capital gain. So when Rich Dad Poor Dad in his book, when he's talking about real estate, he's talking about this passive income sort of deal. Now, trust me, I read it in 2008. For last 12 years, I'm looking for passive income deal. I could not get even one deal in Bangalore. Now I'm hoping after Corona, there is a scope that I may get one or two such deal. But the problem is, if you don't have cash, you'll be in trouble. So are you getting your point or not? It is a good deal. But let's see now. Buy pe click karo par. Click on buy. What do you see now? 400 rupees ka EMI aayega, right? Extra. Cash flow kitna tha? 160. So 160 minus 400. You will actually get $240 minus. Are you able to see kya thing? Are you able to understand? What I said right now, sabko samajh mein aaya? It's a simple mathematics. Again, no pay click karo. I repeat again. You are saying it's an interesting equation. No pay click karo. No. See, the house is giving you $160 cash flow, correct? But if you take a loan, you have to pay 400 rupees EMI. 400. Actually, 160 is the cash flow. So minus 240 is the cash flow. Correct or not? So that means you are in debt, further debt. Though your passive income will increase. But again, this is not the right time for you because you are financially broke. That is why it is not the right time. Deal is good. Timing is wrong. Is it clear to all of you? Just that it's a, because of Corona, suddenly assume you get a house in 60% less price. Maybe a good deal. But because see, basically, if you get a house, assume a 4 BHK house in Bangalore, you're getting 30 lakh rupees in a decent area. Is it a good deal or not? But I'll tell you, problem will come when Corona time comes. People may not have 30 lakh rupees also to pay. That is a problem. Is it clear to all of you? Next, jaldi next. Kya kahan gaye tum? Iska next jao. Go ahead. Who is next? I hope you got multiple concept today. Sasi, go ahead. Kya gaya? Roll. Again, small deal. Now this is again a good one. What do you say? Stock is good one again. Again, understand here. He is having 3,660 as a cash. His monthly expenses are 2,870. He can take a risk of $1,000 at max. That too not advisable because he is not having any cash. But 1,000 ka le lo game ke liye. You can take 1,100 share. Kharid sakte ho. Kharid do. 100 you can buy. Buy. Ab dekho balance sheet. Dekho balance sheet ko. Dekho balance sheet. Let's see balance sheet now. In balance sheet, what do you see in asset column? There is a stock. Observe it. Asset column mein stock aa gaya. But again, if the stock price falls down, this asset can convert into liability also. There is always a possibility. Correct? Na? Good. End. You can end. Next, jaldi. Kiran, get ready. This is the reality of life. Cash. Understand again this. He's a lawyer. His baby is expensive baby. $380 per month cost of living increased. Do you see this now? Is this a reality of life? Suddenly your cost of living will increase. Ab okay kar option nahi, there is no option. You are okay. Now see the balance sheet. Observe the financial statement here. Observe. The moment you observe, what is the expenses now? One child expense $380. Iska cash flow aur kam ho gaya. Dekh pa rahe ho? Are you able to see how expenses increase? That's why they say child is a liability. People don't understand. They get emotional. My child is asset. Yes, you are right. But expenses are increasing. That's a reality. Good. Interesting game. Na? End. Next. Jalli. Who is next? Kartik. Downside. Dekho reality hai ki job se fire ho gaya ye. Ab dekho fire hone ka baad observe. He has to pay 1620 and he lose 2 times. 2 months ka salary ko pay karna padega. Aisa loan nahi hai. Dekho he doesn't have money as a typical scenario of Bangalore software engineers. They don't have more than 2-3 months of saving. Now suddenly job goes away. And they're in deep trouble. Now pay karo option nahi hai tumhara. Pay karna padega. Loan leke pay karna padega. Dekho loan leke pay karoge. Aap pay karo. You take a loan. Dekho. Yes, you have no option. Yes, because you have paid. Dekho observe karo. Dhyan se dekho. Pay karo now. What will happen? I'll tell you. But Karthik case, because job went away, expenses are still there. The expenses he has to pay to bank. So jo expense jo main bata tha example personal loan lena pada to ye take na personal loan to pay off the loan. Samajh mein aa raha hai? That means job agar chali gayi to tum kya kar sakte ho? Tumhare haath mein kuch hai nahi. So under this condition, it is very, 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 very difficult situation. So now, are you able to see how many scenario? Let us stop for some time and revise what all we have learned. Ek baar wapas screen sharing hata do. Let us revise the concept what you have learned. I started with a very simple concept of balance sheet. In that, I showed you multiple things. I showed you income, expenses, asset, and liability. Remember, I four things I showed you. Then during the game, we saw multiple things. What is the one thing I saw? We all saw that you may get laid off. We recently Karthik laid off, right? The laid off for the problem kya rahi hai? If you get laid off, your expenses are not getting laid off. They're still there. That means even if you do not have money, you have to take a personal loan to fulfill your rent, right? अगर आप बैंगलोर में घर के किराए में रह रहे हो या लेट्स से ईएमआई में रह रहे हो वो ईएमआई तो देना पड़ेगा ना बैंक डू नॉट केयर राइट इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग दे हैव दे नीड देयर इंटरेस्ट दे विल पे फॉर इट दैट मींस दैट एक्सपेंसेस विल बी देयर सेकंड कांसेप्ट वी एक्सप्लेन यू वाज रियल एस्टेट कांसेप्ट नाउ रियल एस्टेट इज अ गुड और बैड अगेन नथिंग इज गुड नथिंग इज बैड वी सॉ 2 to 3 सिनेरियोस इन दैट व्हाट वी सॉ देयर वाज अ पैसिव इनकम इन वन हाउस सिनेरियो देयर वाज अ नेगेटिव कैश फ्लो ऑब्जर्व बट दैट नेगेटिव कैश फ्लो डील वाज स्टिल नॉट बैड बिकॉज 100 रुपीस माइनस में फ्यूचर में हो सकता है तुमको कैपिटल गेन मिल जाए बट दोस कैपिटल गेन डील्स आर मेड फॉर होम दोस हु कैन अफोर्ड विदाउट स्ट्रगलिंग व्हाट इज द थंब रूल ऑफ अफोर्डिंग सपोजिंगली इफ आई एम हैविंग 1 year ऑफ कैश एटलीस्ट सपोज मेरा घर खर्चा 1 lakh रुपया है इफ आई एम हैविंग 12 lakh रुपी कैश उसके बियॉन्ड अगर कुछ है मेरे पास लेट्स से आई एम हैविंग 6 lakh रुपी एक्स्ट्रा दैट आई कैन टेक अ रिस्क बिकॉज माई फैमिली इज नॉट स्ट्रगलिंग फाइनेंशियली आई विल नॉट बी इन अ टेंशन The biggest error which majority of us do is we do not have even 2 months of saving and we take up everything on EMI and then later on if any stress comes that shows on our face. I think that is what happened with CCD owner. He was in such a huge EMI and that EMI took such a toll on his head. Though he was a rich guy but he was a poor guy and that stress took him a toll. Recently I'll tell you one of my, not a classmate, he was my friend. He did a suicide on just last 4 months back. Only reason was his EMI toll took such a high toll on his mind and he had no idea how to pay it off. He had 2 children and he was in the EMI of more than 1.5 lakh per month. He was in 1.5 lakh per month EMI per and his salary was hardly 1.6 lakh and things. In between his job went away. In between his job went away in such a deep trouble, he had no option. So what I try to tell you folks, the lesson which I teach you today is that first thing first, boss, EMI ka concept samjho. There are some good debt, there are some bad debt. But There's a right timing. So the way I understood this concept, ask ke 10 saal pehle jab isko padha tha. So what I understood was after going through this game, and I would suggest abhi to pura to khel nahi payenge because it will take long time. So what I suggest, Kiran, all of you, I hope major concept main aapko samjha diya hu. Stock market ko samajh mein aa gaya. You should play at a smaller group. Today I have given you a basic induction to get more subject clarity. Play in a group of 10 people. Kiran bhai, to 10 log milke khelo and try to understand a good deal and a bad deal. So if you understand financial freedom concept, today at least all of you are clear about financial freedom. Who can define what is financial freedom? Financial freedom kya hai? Kaun define karega?
Not spoken yet.
Who will define financial freedom?
Financial freedom is where we have enough money, right combination of money, time and security. When you have all these three, and also let's say my current income is X, in case if I am able to earn two times whatever income that I am earning through passive income, and at the same time I'm able to do all the things that I always wanted to do in my life without sacrificing anything, so that is financial.
If I put it in a simplest term, passive income means something which is not dependent upon your physical presence. Now tell me one thing, who in this world, in his senses, normal senses, don't you believe everybody should have financial freedom? After reading, see, once I read this book, I first time understood. Before that, I had no idea what is financial freedom. And I'll tell you what is the biggest trade-off I did because of to understand financial freedom. Now, this is a very good example I'll give to all of you to understand, because a lot of young people end up wasting a lot of time just to make money. I repeat again, listen carefully. A lot of young people waste a lot of their time only by making money. Now, what does it mean? I'll give you an example. 2008, what I was doing was an ambitious person. I was never sitting in my home and wasting time and watching television. I never did it because I didn't like to waste my time like that. And what I used to do was, in my part time, I was doing get just at present like coach, because coaching is my passion. Similarly, that time I used to do IIT coaching centers. I used to teach some control system, circuit theory, because typical get coaching center, I used to teach. I was passed out from 2006 from IIT, so I had subject knowledge at that time. So I used to do get coaching center. And per weekend I used to make around 10,000 to 20,000 based on how much of demand or supply I used to make. The problem I was facing was, what is the biggest thing I was getting? So in this case, what was happening was, I was getting, let's say, 50 to 60,000 per month, part-time. Is it a good deal or a bad deal? Let's understand. Practically, it was like that. I was making part time 50 to 60,000 rupees along with my job. Is it a good deal or a bad deal? Think carefully and answer. Think carefully and answer. Okay. All of you answer. There's no wrong answer. Actually, it's a good deal if I'm just wasting my time watching television. In a simple layman term, it is a good deal if I'm just wasting my time watching television and watching cricket. Then it's a good deal. Correct or not? Now, let me add part two of this equation. Then you say, well, now listen carefully and answer it. Okay. I'm earning 50,000 rupees part time by doing coaching center work, and it is immediate income. And in between, I get a deal in market. Again, just say in cash flow quadrant, you're seeing some small deals are coming. I got a small deal in my life. The small deal said you invest 20,000 per month for 5 years. Okay, 20,000 per month for 5 years, and invest your weekend time. And in 5 years down the road, you'll become financially free. What it means was, 5 years down the road, you can make 1 lakh rupee of passive income where your physical presence is not required. Listen carefully again, I'm saying, okay. Presently, I am working in Gate Coaching Center in freelancing basis, and I am making 50,000 rupees per month. Okay, now it's fetching me good income. And suddenly, I get a small deal. Just like you get a small deal, big deal. I got a small deal in market. The small deal said you invest 20,000 per month, and your weekend time, whatever time you're having, put in that, and invest 20,000 rupees on top of it, and you don't make any money for first 2 to 3 years. You make zero money. But 5 years down the road, you'll become financially free. Now tell me, which is a good deal? Letting go this 50,000 part-time income and focusing on this financial freedom, which is a good deal, which is a bad deal? Think about it. It's the most complicated equation I've given you right now. Those who can understand this, they can become financially free. Other people will struggle to understand financial freedom. First, who can summarize the question? Because it's a complicated question, who can summarize? Once the question summarized, answer me question. Who can summarize the question which I said right now? What is the question?
Shall I summarize, Vijayji?
Haan ji, please, go ahead.
So, if we are there is one deal, we are doing Gate coaching in the weekend, and it is fetching me 50,000 active income,
which is the immediate income.
Immediate, that is immediate returns. Yeah, so there is another deal which is coming wherein you have to invest 20,000 per month and your weekend time, and you will not get immediate returns. Unlike Gate, you will not get immediate returns.
For how many months or for how many years?
Until 2-3 years maybe.
2-3 years you will not get any income. Remember this carefully. Okay.
But at the end of 5 years, you will be getting passive income.
Correct. Of 1 lakh rupee.
Of 1 lakh rupees.
Now, under this condition, which is a good deal and which is a bad deal? Again, there is no right answer, wrong answer. It's about mindset only. There is no wrong answer in this equation. It's a simple equation. It's like a game. You'll get and which one it is and why it is. Who will say? All of participate. That way you can understand.
Yeah, it's me. Deal 2 is good.
Why?
Because deal 2 doesn't require your physical presence. In case if you continue with deal 1, you have to keep your, you have to spend your time over and over again to earn that. But deal 2 doesn't require
in
that.
Deal 2, what is the biggest sacrifice I'm doing in deal 2?
Initially, you have to forego your passive income.
Correct. Or so investment is there, investment is there.
Yes, there is an amount of cash.
That means the first 3 years when I'm not making any rupees, in first 3 years, I might lose 7.5 lakh rupees, correct or not? True. That is the biggest, and that is what is deciding entrepreneurship. 90% people, the reason they will not become entrepreneur is because of this only, because they will find it very difficult. Now, trust me. Now, again, don't go by me. If you are in the same situation, what would you do? Now, let's understand. If you are in this situation, you are in my situation, what are you going to do? Will you take deal one or deal two? There's no wrong answer. It's just understanding what is your priority right now. If I ask you right now, you gave the same situation, which one would you choose? Deal one or deal two?
See, deal one makes immediate money, so initially we'll opt for that.
Absolutely. But then you'll not have time for that. Your second deal also need time. That's another problem.
And deal two will have an ambiguous situation where you have a doubt whether it might fetch or not.
Correct. But God has a simple rule. You have to have faith to move on. That's why entrepreneurship is so difficult. See, I'll give you a real life scenario. This game, if you play in a real life scenario, it will give you real emotional turbulence. So what will you do? All of them, I want all of the answers. There's no wrong answer. If based on situation, in some cases, it might be requirement or you have immediate income possible, that you're in deep trouble financially. I mean, your present situation might be requiring you to do deal one. Some of you deal two. Whichever, I mean, go ahead. Rest all are confused to participate.
Can I then I will be in a trouble because
what I'm asking if I am listen, I'm not asking, I'm not justifying your answer. All answer is right because you have to convince yourself. I'm just asking that everything has a trade-off. Everything has a trade-off. There's no wrong answer. Whatever answer you're choosing, I'm with you. I'm just giving an answer because the idea is to understand what is the trade-off. That in my case, if I tell you what I did, when I took this deal, what is happening was trade-off is I have done part-time 2-year tuition. The trade-off is happening that all of us have a limited energy period time, correct? Na? This example.
Yeah.
Start career? All of us will start our career if you do masters. You cannot start your career before 26 or 27, most of us, right? There are peak working period is 20 years. In that 20 years, if I have to do, that is what everything has to happen mostly. So under this condition, what is important? Let's say somebody is financially trouble right now, financially broke, then he has no option. He has to take immediate income only. There's no choice. I mean, it's not about that. But if my finances are not in that much of mess, then if I do not invest my time right now for passive income, problem will happen by the time I reach 50 years of age. That point in time, if my dependency is there, then problem is my survival will become in deep trouble. That's why you see a lot of rich people. Let's say Michael Jackson. Well, it's a lot of rich people you've seen. Suddenly they become broke. Why? Because they have only one source of income, that is active source of income. If you see Amitabh Bachchan, there were times when he became broke. Though he was a very rich actor, suddenly he became totally broke. He was financially broke. Then again, he came into KBC. So Amitabh Bachchan will do job, man. Come on, impossible. But then he did job for some time. There's no option. So again, I'm not telling you which is good or bad. Today my goal was to educate you that understand what is passive income, what is active income, what is financial freedom, and what is practical. Now, when I did it, trust me, it was so difficult for me to take the second deal, honestly. Now, say with around first 6 months, I couldn't convince myself. Honestly, I will tell you what happened with me. First 6 months, I could not convince. Then I played this game multiple times. Then I said, when baat to sach hai, if I do not create passive source of income, the problem will happen is I will lifelong be dependent upon myself. And what if tomorrow I'm excited and frustrated today? If I talk about my journey, and today I train also. Now I'll give you one more 3 answers also, so all of you understand. Now, if you want to migrate, now presently you might be not be having it. Let's say you want to migrate. If you have interest in migrate, how many of you want to migrate in future, in next 4 to 5 years, you want to migrate. Presently you might be having only source of income is job. But 5 years from now, you want to migrate. Okay, I also want to become financially free in next 5 years. How many of you are in that group? I mean, who would be interested? Though you may not have any chance right now, you may not have any option right now, but how many of you have interest to migrate there at least? Then I can give you, I'll give you now 2 to 3 skill sets which you will need. I can give you direction to think in this direction that these skill sets are a must. If you want to migrate in future, presently you might be in job because I have also done job for 13 years, so I can educate you. So most of you would be interested. So now let me tell you a practical example. If you want to migrate from E quadrant, just like the book says, E quadrant to B quadrant to I quadrant, ESBI is the quadrant he says. If you have to migrate, I'll tell you, you will require skill set more than money. I repeat again, to migrate, you will require skill set and mindset more than money. Now, what is the skill set needed? I'll tell you an example, practical example. Presently, in your scale of 0 to 10, in a scale of 0 to 10, at present, how much would you rate in terms of sales and marketing? In terms of sales and marketing, at present, how much would you rate? 0 to 10, mein se, apne aapko kitni rating doge? Sales and marketing. If anybody is rating above 3, that means I am assuming you are right now having a sales experience and you are increasing revenue of some company at least. If not, then assumption I am not asking. Practically, kiska sales ka experience hai? Yahan par aapne waqai mein sales ko badhaya hai kisi ka. Agar sales ko badhaya nahi, iska matlab aapka experience nahi hai. You might be assuming and assumptions are many times wrong. How much will you? All of you answer. I want to answer. When all of you answer, the more you answer, the more you learn. At present, how much would you rate yourself in sales and marketing? That's good. I like honest answer. Vinay says 0, that's good. Sasi said 2, 1, 2, 3. Good. I like it. It's a genuine answer. This nice answer. Arun 5, are you in sales background, Arun?
Hi Vijayji. I'm from HR background, HR and sales.
Acha acha, to aapko this thoda experience hai. To baki logo ka to 3 ya 2 se jaa jayega nahi. Correct. That's good. Nice, nice, nice. Very nice. So that's the truth. All of you know it, right? That means if in future you want to do, what do you need? The skill set is a must. Okay, second question I'll ask you, if you really want to migrate from this to that quadrant eventually. Second thing you will need is leadership. Now, what is leadership? Let me explain to you leadership. If you're a manager of a company, okay, and you write a mail that there is a meeting at 10 o'clock, people are supposed to come, they will come. Correct, na? But imagine when you don't have a when you cannot come under. The way I work in my business, in my real life, I don't have any employees. My business model don't have any employees. I don't have any employee at all. Under this condition, making people listen to you is not a joke, because they may not listen to you at all. They say the real test of leadership comes under voluntary organization. Because in voluntary organization, people have, if they can, they can choose not to listen to you. In that case, until you really add value in people's life, until you create a difference in their life, they're not going to listen to you. And that is real leadership. And that leadership, how many of you have real experience of leading people without power, without position? Let's say if you're a manager, you might be assuming you're a leader, but think that if you're not a manager, will they listen to you? Is the question mark. How much would you rate yourself in leadership right now that you do not have position of leading, but still people listen to you? Think about it. As of now, how much would you rate? 0 to 10, mein kitna rating doge apne aapko? Leadership mein. Jaldi jaldi, I'm just asking easy questions. I'm just telling you, agar migrate karna hai, toh kaise migrate karoge? That's good. Whatever the skill set you believe. The second skill set you need is this. Third skill set, which you will need. Just I'm giving you for your own analysis, you can write it down. And this is the direction you should focus on. Third, you will need is conflict handling and communication skill. Communication and conflict handling. Conflict handling means, remember, tomorrow if you work in a business also, there will be a lot of board of directors. And all the board of directors will have a different opinion. And you have to collaborate with them. Somebody will think east, somebody will think west, somebody is thinking north, somebody is thinking south. And you have to work with everybody. And once you work with everybody, there are two ways to work. Either I don't care. You don't listen to me, I'll kick you out. And that is the mindset. And trust me, you'll have deep trouble leading people, and you cannot lead organizations. Your organizations will have a rainbow sort of structure where people will come from all walks of life, all colors of life. And if you cannot learn how to lead them, you'll be in deep trouble. That's where communication is very, very important. Communication and conflict handling is another big area. Agar ye area mein aap focus kar sakte ho, now I'll tell you one good news. I coach a lot of people. If you have interest, I do one-on-one small group coaching also, which is quite affordable. So I make sure that I incorporate this all. Each training costs $600 to $700 per head. But obviously in one-to-one, you cannot afford that much. So I do small mastermind groups of 6-7 people generally I do, where 30,000 rupees I charge for one almost 10 to 12 weeks. It is really worth. I mean, if you learn, I always claim people, you will definitely become better out of it. So these are skill sets I offer. If anybody wants the skill set, you can always approach to me. My mail ID, by the way, all of you can note down my mail ID. bijay@pim.org.in. And when you are contacting me, at least let me know who is coaching you right now in PIM team, because that way I can guide you in the right direction. Okay, my email ID I'm giving you. It is bijay@pim.org.in. So this is the one thing I can offer to you. Skill set wise, if anybody is looking, I can definitely coach you. Now let's say if you think, sir, I want to become financially free also. If that is your goal in future right now, if I want to become financially free, then I also help people through a business opportunity for sure. But they're very limited because everybody don't have mindset. Until the person is having the right mindset. And I always tell them the mindset, how do I design the mindset? I tell them, let's go to the real route. No? Let the rubber meet the road. When I say rubber meet the road, do this analysis for your own personal benefit so that you understand the truth of life. I give them 7 parameters to evaluate 3 businesses. I always tell, before you think about anything, do this practical test. What is a practical test? I'll give you take businesses and evaluate them under this 7 parameters. Write down those parameters. Startup cost, running cost, koi business karo to startup aayega na, startup cost, running cost, time commitment, break even, theek hai, startup cost, running cost, time commitment, break even, risk factor, because there is always risk involved in everything we do. After that, is there any mentorship available, because most of us don't come from business background, so is there somebody who can handhold us? Then 6th most parameter, ye sab circus karne ke baad kya mujhe financial freedom milega? That is most important. Now because you understand financial freedom, I can use this term quite easily. Because most of you don't understand it. So after doing all this circus, can I become financially free? I repeat again, startup cost, running cost, time commitment, break even. And then is there a risk factor? Then is there any mentorship available? And 7th factor which I covered was, after doing all this circus, can I become financially free? Can the business run without me so that I can have time and money freedom? This parameter is required. So if you really want to participate in any business idea, I always tell, do this analysis. And if you find an option, start working on it. If you do not find an option, at least I can help you out through business models. I always help people. I can help you out through business models as well. But again, only those selected people who really are serious about their life, we always tell them, if you are having 3 options, you don't have any option. That is the way John Maxwell already taught me, is that if you have 3 options, that means you have no option. Because It's like focusing one thing consistently for next 4 to 5 years is what is success formula. So I hope I have educated you a lot enough today. I have educated you about certain terms. Play this game again and again. Learn a lot. And if you need any help from my end, do not hesitate to contact me at vijay@pim.org.in. I would love to help you out. If you want any skill set workshops, don't hesitate. I can do certain workshop for you. And if you are at a leading position in your company and you want my assistance, I can do some leadership workshop at your company or something. I mean, anything which you want me to do, I can help you out. So I think we're done. Anything else? If anybody wants to ask a couple of questions, I can help you out. Otherwise, we're done for the day. But play this game again and again. I've just given you today introduction and played some little bit parameters so that you're educated. Just play it 3-4 times, small groups, so all of you learn. Kiran, chote-chote group mein karo, achha rahega, Kiran.
If anyone has any one or two questions, they can ask quickly. Then anyone?
Hi, Vijay. This is Rahm here.
Hi.
I'm audible.
Yeah, you're audible.
So, Vijay, my question is you have explained regarding the liabilities and expenses and stuff regarding the homely EMI and other stuff. So, what if someone wants to invest, start a business? Suppose right now it's a very food business, is a very booming business as of now. Mm-hmm. So someone want to invest into that or some other business starting a consultancy or his own coaching center also, mm-hmm. whatever his field of interest is. Then in that terms, what advice would you give to him?
See, I will a little bit first summarize your question, make sure I understand correctly. What I'm saying is right now, let's say you want to do a business and there are multiple directions, food industry or consulting and all. Any business you want to do, what should you do? Is that a question? Is my understanding correct?
Yes, correct.
So you are actually talking what exactly I'm doing right now, to be very honest. But let me tell you one good news. Presently, my PIM is not fetching me any income as such because I'm still in loss. I have invested more, my returns are less. And I'm not worried. You know why? The way I have done, I'll tell you, very systematic. I'd say I'm really lucky in this regard. When I say lucky, having that wisdom at the young age, at the age of 30, having a wisdom that letting go immediate income for passive income, trust me, it is very difficult for young people. When young age, what happens, patience is very less. And I was very short-tempered at the age of 30. Presently, because of entrepreneurship and all, and meeting with a lot of very little people, my patience have really increased a lot. But in 2008, I was like, if you don't listen to me, you're an idiot person. That's all I was, my personality. But now I don't think like that anymore. I think everybody has their own freedom to do. Now, what I'm trying to say to you, that point in time, I understood financial freedom. So presently, I'm following my passion. You know why I'm able to follow my passion? Because I have created 2 to 2.5 lakh rupee monthly passive income, which do not need beyond 20% of my time. That means I invest in my business for not more than 2 to 3 hours per day. And that is fetching me 2.5 lakh rupee income. So I have another 15 hours to follow my passion. And in the next 2-3 years, my PIM will also fetch income. But again, understand, as long as my PIM is fetching me active income, I'm not much attracted, to be honest. I do not want to do lifelong coaching for money purpose. If it is my passion, I'm following it, that's great. But otherwise, I have understood one thing in my early age of my life, whatever I do, I do not want to work for money. Even if I'm coaching, even if I'm mentoring, I would do it. I would do lifelong, no problem in it. But there's a big difference. When you do it only for money purpose, problem is you'll always be under stress. When you do it, okay, man, I'm enjoying it anyway. So whenever I do it, say I'm here in this session, I know anyway, I like educating people. If there are 40, 50 people who can get educated, I'm excited about it. But if you imagine everything is money-minded, it will not happen. Man, I'll invest for 2 hours. Is it worth? Shall I go there? Will I make 30,000 rupees out of it? Then this will create tremendous stress. So what I would suggest, if you ask my opinion personally, I always give people one simple advice. First of your goals would be create an income source so that at least that much of income source so that your survival do not need your physical presence. If that you can do for the next 5 to 6 years, let's say 5 to 6 years, you can do this. After that, what will happen? You'll have options. You can experiment. This I'm right now experimenting with PIM. I have no problem. Even if I lose my money, I know still I have created enough saving so that my family is not at risk. I can take that risk right now. Risk taking is not a problem. But imagine this would be my first venture. I would be in deep trouble. That is what I mean to say. What I'm trying to say to you is, first thing first, think in terms of financial freedom first. If at all you can get, if you can get an opportunity, great. If not, at least I can help you out for sure. But get a concept of financial freedom first. That will give you mental peace to follow your passion, that even if you don't make money for 2 to 3 years, or even if you end up losing your 10 lakh rupees, you will not be desperate in your life. Otherwise, what will happen, I'll tell you, I'll give a life story of one of my classmates, two classmates of mine. They went to US for 2-3 years and came back. And while coming back, they already have all the three partners invested 20 lakh rupees to open a hotel in Marathali. I'll tell you the exact location also. Marathali, they opened a hotel. It's a story around, I think, 2013 ka baat hoga, 2013 ka baat hai. They invested, that time was a big amount. I mean, sab 20 lakh hai, 60 lakh mein hotel khole hue, theek hai? The biggest assumption they had was that hotel will give them money right away. That was the biggest assumption they had. And they thought that it can be done along with the job. That's another mistake they did. So problem kya tha, main aapko ek live example likhata hu, which they saved me. Actually, they explained, I said, man, thank God I saved my money. So what happened? When the hotel opens for breakfast at 7 o'clock, in back end, wo kitne baje khulti hai? 4 baje, correct? Raat ko 11 baje agar wo public ke liye band hoti hai, to back end mein sara kaam karna padega na, ask your wife, she will say you. Ki jab kitchen wind up hota hai, back end mein bahut sara kaam rehta hai, usko sab setup karne ke liye 1 ghanta nikal jata hai. Which boys who don't go to kitchen, they may not realize. Similarly, jab hotel public ke liye band hota hai, back end mein bahut sara kaam hota hai. So more or less, his sleep was disturbed. Then on top of it, time kahan se nikaloge? And he realized running cost is killing them. Monthly running cost was coming around 4 lakh because employee salary, this and that, 4 lakh rupee running cost. They said, man, it is impossible to sustain in Bangalore without having a backup of 1 to 2 crore. Tremendous trouble. And they ended up winding up in 10 months, I think. Uske baad bola aur paise nahi hamare paas. So what I am trying to tell you, if you are doing for the survival purpose, you are in deep trouble. Always remember, if you want to sustain peacefully, first goal of yours is get financial freedom as soon as possible. And financial freedom will take minimum 5 to 6 years based on your mindset. Your mindset ko badalne mein 1 se 2 saal lagta hai. Most of us come from immediate income mindset, so it is not easy to adapt it. But ek bar agar aapne adapt kar liya, fir 2 saal mein free ho jaoge. Once you're free, you can experiment. I started my venture in 2008. 2014 I came out of my job. 2 years literally I slept and enjoyed. That's all I did. Slept, ate food, played guitar and slept. Then I said, man, mere ko aur bada mission chahiye. But that time I got a lot of coaching experience. Then I said, man, now time has come. I have experience. I know how to run businesses. I know how to coach and mentor people. I think coaching companies should be started. That's where my coaching companies took place. And I started coaching, mentoring, and started approaching a lot of people and helping it out. So that migration has happened. In fact, this I'm going to do for next 10 years. Till 2030, my PIM coaching company will work. By that time, I will sub-franchise it to more than 100 plus organizations so that they can run and I'll make passive income. That's my goal for it. And then I'll start my another company, a book writing company. That's another 10 years goal. I have goal till 60, but I have always found out one thing. Jo bhi kuch kar rahe ho, bhaiya usko properly passive income ke mode mein karke side ho jao. Active ke chakkar mein mat padho because active will only attract you for a certain time. Otherwise, you are in deep trouble. And that's a very deep concept I'm explaining to you. But again, is it the right concept or wrong concept? No. It is just an opinion which I am having based on my experience. So I hope you got answer. It will be helpful for others also. So try it out.
Thanks, Vijay.
Thank you, Ram. Thank you. Good. So I'm sure all of you have questions. If anybody want to learn anything else, you can always reach out to me. You never have to, you know, hesitate to send me a mail. I will definitely help you out. And anybody who want to really understand financial freedom, give yourself 5 years. I'll mentor you for sure. I have mentored a lot of people. I can mentor you also, but it needs a mindset.